Welcome to this brief guide on how to use the aggregate function in Excel. Have you ever been working in Excel, filtering your data, only to find that your totals are still counting the things that you've hidden? It's a frustratingly common issue. But today, we'll not only solve that problem, but I'll introduce you to a powerful tool that can handle a wide range of data challenges. That tool is the aggregate function. Get ready to level up your spreadsheet skills. Let's set the scene. We have a complex table here listing out a bunch of employee data for our HR team. We've got columns for all of the important information. And up here, we're using the trusty sum function to calculate the total salary of all of our employees. Easy peasy. Right? Now imagine that we want to focus on just a subset of our employees. Maybe we want to see what the total is for just the female staff. So we apply a filter. But wait a minute, our total hasn't changed. It's still including the salaries of the employees that we've just hidden. This is a classic Excel pitfall that can trip up even the most experienced users. This is where the aggregate function steps in to save the day. It's like a supercharged version of functions like sum, average, and more, with built-in intelligence to handle filtering and other data quirks. Let's go ahead and replace our sum formula with aggregate. We start by typing equals aggregate and an opening parenthesis. The first argument is the function underscore num. Think of this as the code that tells aggregate what kind of calculation to do. We're going to use 9 for sum, but there are tons of other options available. 1 gives you the average, 4 finds the maximum value, and so on. It's like having a whole toolbox of functions built right in. Next up are the options. This is where we tell aggregate how to behave. We want it to ignore the hidden rows, so we're going to use option 5. You can tell it to ignore hidden rows, skip error values, and even handle nested subtotals. It's all about having total control over your data. Don't forget that we separate these arguments with commas. Finally, we give it the array or reference. This is simply the range of cells that you want aggregate to work on. It can be a single column, multiple columns, or even a named range. In our case, it's the same range of cells that we used for sum. Close the parenthesis and hit enter, and voila. Our total is now correct, ignoring those hidden rows. Aggregate has saved us from a potential headache. But it's far more than just a sum replacement. It's a versatile tool that can handle all sorts of data challenges. For instance, you can nest aggregate functions within each other to perform complex calculations. You can also combine aggregate with other Excel functions like if or index to create powerful conditional calculations. And with a little creativity, you can even use aggregate to drive dynamic charts and graphs that automatically update as your data changes. Today, we've only conquered the pesky sum problem, but there's a lot more potential to the aggregate function. With aggregate in your toolkit, you're well on your way to becoming an Excel master. Now get out there and make those spreadsheets sing, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.